What is our last topic?
Our last topic was nesting.
Okay. For loop not yet
nesting
completed?
And for, sorry?
For loop, right?
For loop, chestunnanu. I'm doing now.
Okay. No issue. Do you have any doubts in a for loop?
No,
right?
No doubts at all. No.
Yeah. If you have any, please let me know so that we will discuss on that.
Okay.
Yeah.
One second.
Okay. The next topic. Okay. If you go for the next topic is like a while loop.
While
Just
loop.
Give me a second. I will show you that also. Yeah. Somewhere here we are now, right?
Nesting for loop.
Okay. The next topic is while. Okay. Try those different diagrams. Okay. With different stars and 1, 2, 3s. Okay. Why? Because in interview they will not ask your bigger program or write a project. Okay. They will ask a small program, but a trickier one they will ask. So better try to clear your hands in a for loop. Okay. Why? Because most of the time we will use for loops only when you are fetching Excel data. Okay, we will not fetch one by one, or we will not read one line after one line. We will simply pass in a for loop. For loop will do the particular action. Okay, it will read all the cells. Got it, right?
Got it.
Yeah. That time we use pandas anyway for reading Excel. Native Python will not support directly for Python. We need to add a few more libraries. Okay. Anyway, we will do that. Don't worry about that. Now our topic is while. Okay. While. Just give me a second. Control S. Okay. For loops completed. Okay. Is this one also completed? Yeah. Control S. Just give me a second. Morning batch. Where is this? Now, screen is visible, right?
Yeah, it is.
Yeah. Now, the next topic is while. While is also conditional based loop only. Okay. While is also condition based loop. Okay. When condition is true, it will execute the inside loop. Okay, it will go to inside the loop. Okay, else it will come out from the loop. Got it, right?
Yeah.
What it will do, if condition is true, it will go inside the loop. If condition is not true, then it will come out from the loop. Okay. Now, okay. We will go with syntax. Okay. Syntax. Here, while. Okay. While after condition. Okay. Colon. Here you need to write your statements. This is about a while syntax. Okay. Now we will go with the actual example. Example 1. Now while. Okay. Before while, I will take one variable a is equal to 10. Okay. What is my variable? A is equal to 10. Now while a equal to 10. Okay. What I am checking? I am checking double equal to, in the sense of equal. Okay, whether a equal to 10 and 10 equal 10. Okay, then I want one small statement. Okay, like a print inside while loop. Now, okay, observe this one. Yeah. So what is this? My condition is true. Okay. My condition is true. So like while is unstoppable loop. Okay. While is unstoppable. Unstoppable loop. Okay. Until condition fail. So observe this one. It is going continuously. Now to stop this, we need to press Ctrl C. Okay. Ctrl C, that is like a keyboard interrupt. Got it right?
Okay.
So what we are doing here, okay, if condition is true, okay, if condition is true, it will enter into the loop. If condition false, okay, if condition, okay, wait, Ctrl Z. Now example 2, okay, so what I am writing is like a 10 above, okay, 10 above, so A is 10, what I am telling, 10 above 10, this is a wrong, so here somewhere I am writing one more print statement outside while, okay, outside while. So this is a, this much gap is there, right? This gap, this is called indentation. Okay, indentation. If you give this indentation, automatically this is inside while loop. Okay, this is inside while loop. If you are not giving indentation, okay, that is like outside the while loop. Now observe this one. Okay, I got only one line. Okay, I got only one line, that is outside while loop. Why? Because 10 greater than 10. Okay, this is a wrong. As a mathematical rules, this is wrong. So I am getting only this line, 37 line only as a output. Getting right?
Yeah.
Okay, here I am getting like a is 10. Okay, A is 10, 10. Okay, here I will write 10 greater than 10. Like this I am writing. This is mathematically wrong. Okay, mathematically wrong. So here condition false, so it will not enter into this loop. Okay, it will not enter into this loop. It will print directly this line. Got it right?
Yeah, got it.
Okay, now guys, I will go with one more example. Example 3, you can write, here a direct condition also you can write, something like 20, okay, like this also. If you don't want to give variables, okay, if you don't want to give the variable or if you don't want to pass the variable, that time you can give direct number, that is also fine. Now observe this output. Yeah, it is going continuously. Okay, if you have any doubt, what I am doing here, I am taking like a one I variable. Okay, I is equal to one I am taking. Okay, here I is equal to one. Okay, now I cut this line from here and I will press somewhere here and I will print I. Okay, I will print I. Now Ctrl S. Where I am now? Python, inside Python, evening batch 3. Okay, I will create one more folder, while loop. Okay, while, inside while, what is my file name? While test 1. Okay. Now I am stopping this one, Ctrl C here. Once again I am compiling this. Now observe the output. Yeah, observe the number, that is enough anyway. Why? Because we are checking whether the loop is going continuously or not. If I leave like this, it will go continuously, guys. Okay, even I also not tested above than 1 hour, but it will continuously print. Why? Because we already seen like a Bahubali numbers. Okay, the much bigger numbers we seen. So that much bigger number it will go.
Okay.
Got it right? Anyone having any doubt? Now, one monkey fellow is there. Okay, one monkey fellow is there. Okay, or you can consider it as an interval question. Okay, monkey fellow is there. Now, he wrote like this. Now, guess the output and tell me.
It will.
You are able to see my screen, right?
Yeah. I can see your screen.
Yeah. Now, what is my output for this one? Whether it will print or not, it will give some error. What? I need a guess only. Okay. I don't want accurate answer. I am looking.
I think it will print.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think it will print.
Your voice is very low.
Yeah. Hello.
Please.
Yeah, I think it will print.
Yeah.
Inside print. While loops.
Yes. It is true actually. So here by default what we want here the condition should be true. Okay. Here the condition should be true. Okay. Here what you are writing that is not important. Okay. The condition should be true. Now anyway we are directly writing true. Okay. One more monkey fellow, what he will do, see. Okay. Now, here, false. Now, I am stopping this one. Yeah, before compiling this one, please give the answer.
Outside the while?
Yeah, just give me a second.
Yeah. I'll try this one.
Hello? ఏం లేదు డాడీ, ఖాళీనే ఉన్నా. పంపలేదు డాడీ, నిన్న నుంచే స్టార్ట్ అట. నిన్న ఓపెన్ కాలేదు, ఇలా ఇప్పుడు చేస్తాం, తిన్నాక చేస్తాం. ఏ పదే కడిది, నిన్న నుంచి స్టార్ట్, 20 తారీఖు నుంచి స్టార్ట్ అన్నది. అవునా, రైతు ఇచ్చిన ఏం లేదు దీనికి మరి జూనియర్. సరే అండి, నేను ఇస్తాను అంతే అంతే కానీ అంతే కానీ అవును అంతే ఉంటే ఉంటే హైదరాబాద్ కూడా ఉండొచ్చు, చెప్పలేం సెంటర్లు బాగా మంది రాస్తే. పోయినసారి నాకు ఇక్కడనే ఇవ్వలేదు హైదరాబాద్. సరే కదండి, లేదు అండి సౌత్ కూడా, సౌత్ కూడా స్టార్ట్ చేస్తా. గట్టనే ఉంటుంది గవర్నమెంట్ నౌకరీ అంటే. ఎవ్వరికి ఎవ్వరు ఏమి ఇయ్యారు డాడీ. అంతే కదా, అంతే కదా. అదే ఇక ఆమె బిజీగా ఉంది కదా పోనీ తీర. చేస్తాడండి. ఇలా చేస్తా కన్ఫర్మ్. నిన్ననే చేద్దాం అనుకున్నా కానీ అది డిలే ఉండే. సరే రేపు చేద్దాం తీ అని చెప్పి ఆయన. ఓ వచ్చే 7 తారీఖు వరకు ఉన్నది కానీ లేదు, నేను ఇప్పుడు చేస్తా కానీ ఇవన్నీ చేస్తా. అదే కానీ అదేలే. సరే అండి చేస్తా, అప్లై చేస్తా. తినలే తినలేడు అండి, ఇద్దరం తినలే, వండుతాను. ఏ మంచి నాన్న మాట్లాడతారు ఏమన్నా? అంత లేదు, ఆ లవ్ ఎల్లు వస్తాడు ఏమో బాగా చూడలేక. లవ్వ మోకాలది నెల అయింది కదా, మళ్ళా రమ్మన్నాడట. అదే అదే మళ్ళీ ఒక 2 సూదులు కొడతాడు రా గోవాన పైన. అంతేగాని తిన్నారండి. సరే సరేనండి. సరేనండి. మనం అయితే ఇంకా మంచిది కదా. సరే కానీ చెప్పి ఉన్నాడు ఎవరి పేరు అయితే ఏమున్నది, దాంట్లో చేసేది ఏమున్నది, పూసేది ఏమున్నది. అదే కానీ కొనిరా, ఎవరైతే ఉన్నారు మంచిగా బతకాలి. అందరం మంచిగా ఉంటే ఒకరికొకరు ఇచ్చుకోమని. ఇప్పుడంటే ఇది మంచి లేక ఏదో తిట్టుకున్నాడు అవుతుంది కానీ, అందరం మంచిగా ఉంటే ఒకరికొకరు ఇచ్చుకోమా. డాడీ చెప్తున్నావు డాడీ, నీకు ఒక్కటి చెప్తున్నావు. నా అన్నదమ్ములు మంచిగా ఉంటారు, అమ్మ ఈ అప్పులన్నీ తీరిపోతాయి, వీళ్ళు వడ్డీ కట్టే పని ఉండదు అని ఆలోచించే నేను గంత సాహసం చేసినా, లేకపోతే నాకేం పని చెప్పు. పోనీలే ఇంకా మళ్ళీ తలుచుకుంటే బాధని అంత. అదే కానీ చేస్తా చేస్తా డాడీ. లేదు లేదు చేస్తా అబ్బా, ఎందుకు గవర్నమెంట్ నౌకర్ అంటే తక్కువనా? ఒక 40 సంవత్సరాలు 30 సంవత్సరాలు ఉండేది. సరే డాడీ. సరే డాడీ, పోదు పోదు కానీ. ఎందుకు ఆదివారమే ఉంటుంది లే కానీ, అది మాత్రం ఆదివారమే ఉంటుంది డాడీ. ఇద్దరిది అప్లై చేస్తాను. నిన్న ఆమె కూడా అని ఉండే, ఆమె ఇక డిఎస్సి పడుతుంది అని వాళ్ళ అన్నయ్య చెప్పిండు. అయితే ఈ బావ వల్ల పని వస్తుందని నేను చెప్పిన, ఇక అది వచ్చేదాకా ఏదైనా పట్టుకొని చదువుకుంటుంటా అని చెప్పేసి. సరే డాడీ. அம்மா நாளைக்கு நடி யா வெரி சாரி ராபி யா இஸ் இட் இஸ் ஐ மடபுள் ஹலோ ஹலோ ராபின் ஆர் யூ தேர் இஸ் ஐ மடபுள் ஹலோ
ஹலோ ஆ யா யா ஹலோ
ஓகே ஓகே சாரி கால் ஃப்ரம் ஹோம் ஸோ ஐ பிக்ட் தட்
ஓகே ஓகே நோ இஷ்யூஸ்
யா நவ் நவ் வாட் வி டன் டில் நவ் வி டன் லைக் அ ஒன் கண்டிஷன் வில் டேக் த சம்திங் லைக் அ ஒன் கண்டிஷன் ஓகே வைல் லூப் வில் டேக் அ ஒன் கண்டிஷன் இஃப் கண்டிஷன் இஸ் ட்ரூ இட் வில் கோஸ் இன்சைடு ஓகே இட் வில் கோஸ் இன்சைடு otherwise it will directly come out from the loop and it will print outside the condition okay outside the statements yeah. it will pass okay if condition true it will goes inside and after that it will come outside also okay both will execute okay
okay
when condition is true it will go inside it will execute inside the block and okay it will execute inside the block and it will execute outside the block also
okay.
okay like this it will execute okay so this indentation is a very important factor this one the gap
what it called
sorry
name of gap
indentation sorry
indent decision
not decision I will type it just do it
okay okay please
is it visible
indentation okay
indentation.
Okay yeah yeah
okay.
indentation
yeah now likewise you need to give everywhere okay not only this one if loop also we seen this indentation
okay
right so now this is fine if I execute this one false so indirectly it will come out from the loop and it will print this one okay it will not go inside this okay it will directly goes to outside of the block okay
in the true condition
yes
hello
yes yes please
in the true condition it is continuously giving the it is repeating the loop right unstoppable it
yes.
right
yes yes
how can what about the print outside the while in the true whether is a true condition
okay once this complete statement is done okay once this complete statement is done then it will print this loop okay we will check that okay just give me a second
okay.
first of all I am showing like a these are something like interview questions okay these are something like interview question they will not show when you are writing your code okay you will not give this kind of small words okay this kind of small true word or false word you will not give you definitely you have one condition okay when you are working with a project there will be some condition then only you will use while loop for loop something like that you will use with the conditions only you will not go and test like it is true do something it is false do something like that we will not write okay this is something like an interview question okay now two more I will show you then after I will discuss or something like I will discuss now only while wait while okay before while I will take one variable a is equal to 20 okay a is equal to 20 a below okay a below 40 okay a below 40 a below 40 a plus equal to 1 okay what I am writing indirectly what I am writing here I am writing like a equal to a plus 1 okay a plus 1 I am doing here now what I am doing I am printing a okay what I am writing first of all what is my condition my a value okay what is my default a value is a 20 okay below 40 okay below 40 then check the condition, like that we are saying. So if I come here and check, this condition is true, right? True, right? So it will come inside the loop. But what is my a value? What I am doing here? Here I am doing like a is equal to a plus 1. Okay, a is equal to a plus 1. So what it will happen? My a value is 20. Okay, a value is 20. But what I am doing? I am incrementing it with 1. Okay, so indirectly, what is my a value? Is a 21. Okay, then it will print the value. What is my a value? It is a 21, right?
20.
This is what assignment operator, right? This is my assignment operator. So what I am doing, 21, it will print first. Okay, then it will goes to, okay, it will goes to here and it will check the condition. Now 21 less than 40. 21 less than 40. This condition is also true. Okay. True. This condition true. Where it will come? It will come inside the block. Okay. Inside the block. Now, A is equal to 21. What I am doing? 21
plus 1. Plus 1.
Plus 1. Now, what is my value? 22.
22.
Okay. My value is 22. Now, I am passing this 22. Means, I am printing this 22 here. Okay. And after printing, where it will go? It will goes here. Okay, again checking
again
the condition. Loop. Now what will happen? 22, okay, 22 less than 40. Okay, again it will increment this operation. Again it will print as a 23. Okay, then it will print 23 and it will goes here. Likewise it will increment up to, okay, after 39 case I will tell you. Okay, A is equal to, now A is equal to 39. Okay, 39. Below 40, this one, right? So a is equal to 39 plus 1, this operation will done. Now a is 40. What I am checking, 40 will print. Okay, definitely 40 will print, but after 40, okay, after 40 it will come here, right? Come here. What is my a value? 40. 40 less than 40, this is wrong, right? 40 less than 40, this is wrong. Mathematically, this is wrong. So, what it will do, it will not come out from the loop. It will come out from the this block. Okay. This is my block, right? Okay. So, this will come out from the block. Anyway, after this while, I don't have any statement. So, it will not print anything. Okay. Now, observe the output. Yeah. I got the 40, right? So 21 is my first value, second value, like that it will increment one by one. Okay, once it reached to 40, okay, it reached to 39 only. Okay, 39, a value will be automatically here 40. 40 less than or equal to 40, it is mathematically wrong. So it will stop here. Likewise you can stop the while loop. Okay, you don't write like a false true. Okay, if you write like that, either it will not execute or it will execute infinite times. Okay, it will execute infinite times. So better write one condition only. Okay, whenever you are writing in a project, definitely you will write one condition only. Don't worry about that. This type of tricky questions asked in interviews only. Now anyway, two more interview questions I will ask, then after we will discuss with the other topic. Okay, we will discuss with the other topic. Now while one print testing. Okay, print testing. Now tell me what is output for this one. Guess, any guesses? And one testing. More thing also, while zero print not testing. Now I need answers for these two.
While one is testing, it will compile.
Okay.
It will print as testing.
Okay. This what
second condition was
you are saying, right?
It will execute. It will not execute.
This will not execute.
Yeah.
Okay. This is very fine. Okay. This will not execute. And here, how many times it will execute? Whether one time, two times, 10 times, or 20 times?
One time.
Why one time? Any guesses? or any explanation for that?
Search means we are condition was only one, right?
Okay. First of all, we will go with this one. Now observe. Okay, it is not printed anything. No output here displayed.
Okay.
Here no output. Okay, this is very fine. Now if I go and check here, what I am saying? Okay, what is mean by true? What happened with this output? What I got in this case? 56 to 61 lines. What is my output?
Your output was infinite. Infinite time it will loop.
Sorry?
Infinite time it will repeat.
Yes. So anyway, what is the Boolean value for true?
One.
True means how much? True means how much?
It is 1.
Okay. Bool 1 I am writing. What is that? True, right?
True.
So if I write bool true. What is that? Anyway, it is true only.
True.
Okay. True value, okay. Remember this one. True value is 1. Okay. True value. True is equal to 1. Okay. False is equal to 0.
0.
False is equal to 0. Got it, right? Now,
got it.
Here I am giving indirectly true. Now tell me exact output.
It will continue.
Okay. It will print unlimited times. Okay.
Infinite
unlimited times.
Infinite times.
Yeah. So, don't write like this. Okay. But if you go ATM, okay. If you go ATM, there will be any count like you are a 10,000 customer for this ATM. So, we are not executing. Our process of execution is the last boundary. Like that it will print?
No.
No, it will not print like that, right?
It will not print.
Okay, suppose whether it will give like 1 lakh, 2 lakhs or 10,000, not 10,000, like 10 lakhs, 20 lakhs or 1 million after it will show? Whether they wrote on condition, something like this many customer after it should return something?
No, not like that.
Okay, that is you aware, okay? It should not stop for years and years.
Okay.
All right. That is the one bigger block. Okay. Anyway, it will continuously monitor for your card. Okay. It will monitor for your card and it will ask you for password. There will be some but certain block. Okay. That block will execute n number of times. Okay. Likewise, in that cases, you can use a while one. Okay. While true.
Okay.
Like that you can write or while some condition. Okay. If a card is a read. And I have card number. That time you can go with these type of conditions. But don't write this type of condition directly. Okay. If you aware. Okay. If this is what I am looking for this many times. Or something like infinite times I am looking. Then that time you can go with this logic. Okay. It is fine.
Okay.
No issue. Now. This is about for loop. If you have any doubts, we will discuss on that. Otherwise, we will... proceed further topics.
Yeah. Proceed for further topic.
Yeah. Now. Control N. So break continue pass. Okay. Break continue pass. Now. Control 4. Break continue pass. Okay, now break will stop the execution at a break will stop the execution at a, when it reaches the break keyword. Okay, break keyword. We will see with the syntax. Okay, syntax it will stop there itself. Okay, when you receive the break keyword, okay, break is also one keyword. Once you receive this break keyword, execution will stop there. Okay, execution will stop there. So observe this one. Something like a, if you are in, okay, we will go with the for loop. Okay, you can use any loop. Okay, you can use in if, while, okay, for anywhere you want, there you can stop. So I in range 0 to 10 times I am taking, okay, or how many times you want, that many times you can take. I am taking 100. Now if I print, okay, if I print I, okay, if I print I, now anyway we are looking for syntax, right? Sorry, just give me. Somewhere here you can write a one condition, okay, condition. Here you can write a break, okay. Here something like a, I'm writing range, okay. Range, if you are giving any range also fine. Now if we implement this example, okay, now range I am taking 0 to 100. Okay, range I am taking 0 to 100. Now before taking a break, okay, control 1. Okay, I am printing this, whether it is printing or not, and like that I am checking. Now, yeah, it printed up to 100. Okay, 0 to 99, indirectly 100. Yeah, 0 to 99. Now, here, what I am writing is, I equal to 50. Okay, this is what my condition. Okay, I will increment 1 by 1, 1 by 1, 1 by 1, like that it will increase. Okay, once it reaches the 50, okay, once it reaches the 50, okay, what I want is, I want break, okay, I want to break the process, okay, I want to break the process. Now, observe this one. So, previously it is up to 99, right? Up to 99, now observe the output. It is up to 50 only. What we are doing, once the condition we got, okay, there we can break the execution, okay, there we can break the execution. Now I'm going with a one more example. Wherever you want, you can break there itself, okay. You can take at a 10th line, 20th line, wherever you want, there itself you can do that, okay. I want at a 10th line only. Now compile this. So this is what my output, okay. What it is doing, it is stopping at the condition, okay. What is my condition? My condition is I equal to 10, okay, I double equal to 10. So once we receive this condition, what if loop will do, okay, what if loop will do, it will execute, okay, once the condition is true, okay, once the condition is true, it will enter into this loop. Okay, it will enter into this loop. What we are writing here, we are writing like a break. Okay, break we are writing. So what it will do, break will stop the cursor. Okay, break will stop the cursor. Remember this much, that is enough. Okay, now we will take with the while condition also. Okay, while I, okay, I below 20, okay, anyway I will mention I here, I is equal to 1, okay, I equal to 1. Now if I, okay, before that I need to increment I, right? I, one more minute, guys. Hello. Yeah, हाँ मम्मी मंचना
बताइए।
मंचे मंचे तिन्न इंका तिटा पद निम्स मंचदे रोटे सर मंच पान माटता Yeah, okay. Now, okay. I am giving like one condition. Okay, here I equal to I plus one. I am directly writing now. Okay, if I reaches to 10, okay, if I reaches to 10, I reaches to 10, then I want a break. Okay, I want a break. Now observe this one. What happened? Okay. We want to print this I. Okay, I. Now observe the output. Yeah. Once it reaches the 10. Okay. Once I reaches to 10, then what it will do? It will stop the execution. Otherwise, if you are not giving any break here, okay. If you are not giving any break here, if you are printing I here, okay. If you are printing I here, control X. Okay, now observe this one. So it is printed only at that particular place. Okay, it is printed at that particular place. Anyway, if you write here, it will print all the lines anyway. We will see this one. Control. Okay. Here I will write like a testing. Okay. Here I will write like a control V. Now, observe this one. Yeah, when it reaches to 10, okay, when it reaches to 10, it will print a testing. After that also it will print. Okay, after that also it will print. If you write break, okay, if you write a break, it will stop at that particular time. Okay, now observe this one. Once it reaches to 10, okay, once it reaches to 10, it will print a testing and it will stop a break. Okay, got it right? Now the next keyword, okay, the next keyword is a continue. Okay, the next keyword is a continue. Now continue is also similar keyword, okay, but it will continue the loop. Okay, it will continue the loop. Okay, continue also keyword. Okay, continue also is a keyword. Now observe this one. Okay, here I am not printing. Okay, here I am not printing. Here I am printing I. Okay, here control X. Okay. Okay, don't write a break now, write a continue. Continue. Now observe the output so that you will get the idea. So what happened? Okay, what I will do, I will write like this. Okay, I above are equal. Now, okay, what is the first thing we will see? So what happened? Until 50. We are not printing. Okay, we are not printing anyway. That is not our issue. So once we reaches some condition, okay, once we reaches at some condition, before that it is having a break or something. Okay, if we are having a break, but after particular time, okay, after particular time, if you want to run that loop again, okay, if you want to run that loop again, you can use continue keyword. By using continue keyword, the loop will run again. Okay, the loop will run again. Now I will show you one more thing. Control V. Here I am writing two statements. Okay, break and this one also. I below 10, break. Okay, I below 10, break. But I above 50, we are giving continue. Okay, so for that, what I will do, I will print I here and here. Okay, observe the output, guys. Then I will explain what happened. It is printed 0 only. Okay, so what we will do, what happened in this case, I will explain you now, then after you will understand. So continue will continue the loop, but break will stop the break. Okay, what it will do, it will stop the execution there itself. Okay, once you receive the break statement, okay, once you receive the break statement, it will stop there itself. Okay, it will not go for next one. So cursor come out from this loop, cursor come out from this loop. So little careful with the break and continue. Okay, break is very important anyway. Wherever you want to stop that process, okay, wherever you want to stop that process, or at particular time you want to come out from that particular loop, okay, that particular iteration, that time you can use break. So what will happen, cursor will come out from that particular loop. Okay, cursor will come out from that particular loop, otherwise it will be there itself. Okay, now so don't write this statement and these statements here. Okay, write this one or this one. Okay, or you write a continue first, then after you write a break. Okay,
okay,
now got the continue keyword, right? Now we will go with one more keyword called pass. Okay, pass. Okay, sometime in a quiz we will say like a pass, right? So if you don't know the answer, if you don't know the answer, you will not say wrong answer, you will tell like a pass. Okay, pass. What it mean is something like you don't aware of the answer, or you not aware of exact answer, so that you are saying like my turn is give to another guy. Okay, my turn you should give to another guy, like that. If you don't aware something to write, okay, in programming side, if you don't have certain information about the block, okay, we will call these as the blocks also. So if you don't aware, or if you don't aware the information about the block, you can write pass. Okay, you can write a pass keyword. Okay, so what will happen if you don't write pass? What will happen if you write pass? What will happen, we will see now. Okay, you are taking like a something. Okay, these lines you don't want. Okay, these lines if you don't want, then observe the output. Indentation error. Okay, indentation error. Anyway, what I am doing, I am removing this one. Okay, I am removing this one. Now observe this one. Okay, block is not yet completed. Okay, block is not yet completed. If you not write anything, okay, it will show this error. So better for that, if you don't aware what to write inside a for loop, you can use pass keyword. Now observe this one, it will not do anything. Okay, but execution flow will not stop. Okay, execution flow will not stop. It will go continuously. Okay, it will go continuously. It will not print anything. Okay, not only here. Okay, not only here. In if condition also, if if true or something like a, if a or I will write like a 10 below 20. Okay, below 20. You don't aware what to write. Okay, your clients are not mentioned anything. That time you can't write your own words. Print testing. Don't write like that. You can use simply pass statement. What it will do? It will pass the condition. Okay, it will not print anything. Here if you observe, here it will not print anything. Okay, but it is not showing like an indentation error. Okay, indentation error it will not show. Okay. Here, okay, something like you can write pass. No, not only if you can use anywhere, guys. Okay, in a class, in a while, in a functions. Okay, wherever you want, you can write. Okay, I am going with one function def fun1. Okay, fun1 is my function name, but I don't know what to write. Okay, what to write, but I want that function. Okay, I want that function. That time you can write a pass. Okay, fun one. Now observe the output. It will not give any error. Okay, it will not give any error. It will print the output. Got it right?
Got it.
Break, continue, pass.
Pass.
Robin, we will stop the session here. Okay, why? Because they two are not there. Maybe they will also again they will ask for what happened like that. So better we will stop here. Okay, if they understood with the video, then it is fine. If they are not understanding, then I need to take this class. So it is little hectic if I go one by one topic. So anyway, we completed two topics. Okay, one is a while and one is a something like a break, continue, pass.
Break, continue, pass.
Yes. So please try this and better free your hands in for loop. That is very important. Wherever you go, for loop will comes with you like that. Arch
dog.
Okay. So something like a for loop. Every concept. Okay. Not only for loop. Not only while loop. Every concept is important. Why? Because we don't know which kind of client we will get. Whether if he writes on core Python, then we require all the concept. Okay.
Okay.
So better try to learn each and every concept, and especially you. Why? Because Vinay inform like take little care on you. So if you find any difficulty, okay, at least try 1 hour daily. Okay, if you find any difficulty, please let me know so that we will work on that.
Okay, fine.
Yeah. So what I am doing here, I am stopping the session. Okay, we will continue tomorrow.
Okay.
Yeah. Thank you, Ram.
Okay. Yeah. Fine. Good night.
Yeah. Good night.